Power of Thoughts, Law of Attraction, The Secret, Manifestation of Things in Your Life. It is a little known but highly powerful principle of thought forms which is behind all these ideas. A good understanding of thought forms and how they are applied is an important aspect of magic and practical Kabbalah. In this video, we explain the principle and power of thought and thought forms from the mystery student's point of view. Stay tuned to learn about the 5 requirements for successful magic actions, so you can create powerful thought forms that work. Brotherhood of the Eternal Light, teaching the Western mysteries. The essence of the mysteries. Thought forms. The 5 requirements for successful magic actions. Create powerful thought forms that work. The term thought forms originates from occultism. In his book, Introduction to Magic and Meditation, Salomo Baal Shem defines a thought form as a concentrated thought focused at one point by the trained will of the magician, which is able to effect far-reaching changes of reality. Such a thought attains its own efficacy and endurance. Kabbalistic view. From a Kabbalistic point of view, thoughts and thought forms originate in the mental plane and they exist in the astral plane. The creative inspiration of Netzach, the Sephirah of creativity and lower prophecy, assumes a suitable shape in Hod, the Sephirah of analytical and logical thinking, and thus becomes a thought form. In Yesod, the principle of the subconscious, this thought form finally becomes alive and active in the astral dream consciousness. This happens through the power of the emotions and the devotion of the mystery student. In Yesod, the thought form also gains access to the collective unconscious of mankind. Application. When the magician wants to achieve or obtain something through a magical action, then he forms a corresponding thought form. This thought form will become active in the astral plane, similar to a search engine that looks for whatever is desired, or it will create the circumstances that are required to achieve the goal in a natural way. Magic is in fact neither sensational nor dramatic, at least not in the way of Hollywood movies or film series. In recent years, similar concepts have emerged, for example the Law of Attraction or The Secret or other ways of manifesting what you wish for. Why do they sometimes lack efficiency? These concepts have been detached from the mystery context and are therefore sometimes misunderstood or incomplete. The 5 requirements for successful magic actions and creating powerful thought forms that work. The prerequisites for a successful magical action are the following. If a goal is not worthy to happen, it will not become reality because it must be in accordance with the divine plan and divine will. The goal must be defined precisely and clearly. The mystery student focuses on this one single goal. This also means that he no longer gives any attention to anything that conflicts with his goal. The goal must be visualized in a suitable, detailed, and lively manner. The thought form is then filled with emotional power. Salomo Baal Shem explains, "Magic can turn the possible into reality." This means that the result of a magical action will always take place within the framework of the laws of nature. Aleister Crowley wrote the following in Magic in Theory and Practice. Magicians have too often been foolish enough to suppose that all classes of magical operation were equally easy. They seem to have assumed that the almighty power of God was an infinite quantity in presence of which all finites were equally insignificant. One day is with the Lord as 1,000 years, is their first law of motion. Faith can move mountains, they say, and disdain to measure either the faith or the mountains. If you can kill a chicken by magic, why not destroy an army with equal exertion? With God, all things are possible. This absurdity is an error of the same class as that mentioned above. The facts are wholly opposed. 2 and 2 make 4 in the astral as rigorously as anywhere else. The distance of one's magical target and the accuracy of one's magical rival are factors in the success of one's magical shooting in just the same way as in Bisley. The law of magical gravitation is as rigid as that of Newton. The law of inverse squares may not apply, but some such law does apply. So it is for everything. You cannot produce a thunderstorm unless the materials exist in the air at the time, and a magician who could make rain in Cumberland might fail lamentably in the Sahara. One might make a talisman to win the love of a shopgirl and find it work, yet be baffled in the case of a countess, or vice versa. One might impose one's will on a farm and be crushed by that of a city, or vice versa. So we can see that in order to practice magic and to develop and apply our thought power effectively, it is necessary to know the hidden or occult laws of nature. Learn more about Kabbalah, magic and the Western mysteries in our videos and our free online courses. Some parts of the knowledge and certain techniques can, however, only be taught and properly learned in direct training from teacher to student. Therefore, we'd like to invite you to also attend one or more of our regular workshops. So, if you are seriously interested in spiritual training, personal development, and the study of the wisdom of the Holy Kabbalah and the Western mysteries, then our workshops are perfect for you. If you want to learn more about thought forms and practical magic, and how to get what you want in life, then attend our workshops on practical Kabbalah, called Kabbalah Ma'asit, and on the magical power of thought forms and the machinery of the astral plane. Further information can be found in the links in the video description. We hope you enjoyed our video. If you would like to support our work, then please like, share and subscribe. See you in the next video.